Okay, thank you very much for attending here in Burt at the, what is probably the last official one of these podium stops anyway. In this campaign, as you know, I've been in practically every townland in Ireland. I've seen firsthand what I often describe as being absolutely uplifting, and that is the patience and the resilience and the dignity of our own Irish people. And these precious qualities are actually based on something that is even more precious still, and that's what I call national pride. Pride in who we are, pride in what we can do, and pride in what we can be. Today, yes, we have to tell the truth. We are living, in many cases, with a national heartbreak. Reeling from the national confidence trick pulled on us by the government and those to whom they ceded power, the developers and the banks. Every week, as we know, and from this historic county of Donegal included, 1,000 mothers and fathers watch their children pack up their lives, put their degrees in beside their dollars and their bitter disappointment as they head for Sydney or Brisbane or Vancouver or the United States. Today, another generation of Irish is building the future of another country. But tomorrow, all of that can start to change, because tomorrow is the People's Day. Tomorrow, the people go to the polls. As Democrats, we have to have our say, and tomorrow, in that small private space, people will pick up their pan Luis. They will make a personal choice that will have massive public consequences. Not just for this year or for next year, but indeed for generations to come. Tomorrow, as they pick up their pencils and mark their ballot paper, I want to ask the people of Ireland to turn their anger into action and vote with their power, vote with their pride, vote for our plan, the only plan that will get Ireland working. I want them to show their confidence in the future of our country by voting for something, our plan, as against voting against something. Because if this election is to take the political pulse of our nation, I want every beat and every vote to show a nation that looks with hope and generosity and courage to the future, not with regret or hurt and bitterness of the past. Just as grudges paralyze us in our own lives, root us in the pain of the past, they will do the same to us as a nation. And that has been one of the major problems, the kind of politics that has brought us to this juncture, the politics of pollution and corruption of public life. It wasn't a reflection of people's lives, or people's experiences, or people's aspirations. That is not to say that we can forget the past, or that we should forget the past. We don't, and we can't, nor should we. In fact, with our plan to get our country working, we are saying, never again. Never again can such a travesty be allowed to happen. Because our plan, our government, will take the values of the people's private lives and put them firmly at the heart of public life. And those values essentially are integrity, and compassion, and kindness, and respect, and honour, and humility, and solidarity, and courage, and generosity, and truth. Politics in this country has been practiced at too much of a remove, both from the people's lives and from the people's standards. We have to close that gap between government and the people, between politics and the people, because it was in that gap that the rot started and that the rot flourished. Tomorrow then, the people are in charge. Governments may govern, but it is the people who rule. And because they do, I want to ask people to vote with good heart, to vote with their pride, to vote for the future, and to vote for Fine Gael. Because we are the party with the credible and sensible plan for our country and for our people. The only plan that will get them and that will get Ireland working. Tomorrow then, is the people's day. It is their election, it is their country, it is our country, and our people that they're voting for. And I ask them, all across the land, to consider carefully the message that we have put before them in the last 3 to 4 weeks, and to vote for that plan as being the only credible way to start a new beginning, to bring our country in a new direction, and to restore pride and confidence and respect for the Irish, both at home and abroad. Thank you.